that he was making. Now, at the same time that Austin was doing all this stuff, Wittgenstein was challenging the idea that language only serves one purpose, to describe. And Wittgenstein thought we ought to recognize a whole lot of different functions of language. And indeed, Wittgenstein says that there are, strictly speaking, an indefinite number, a countless number of uses of language. Now, I often read in intellectual histories how much Austin was influenced by Wittgenstein. That is absolutely false. I knew Austin very well, and he was totally colorblind where Wittgenstein was concerned. I used to try to get him to argue about Wittgenstein, and he was a very intelligent man, but mostly what he said about Wittgenstein wasn't all that smart. He was totally unsympathetic. Wittgenstein was a kind of a mystical middle Central European who was full of deep and profound and often mystical ideas. Austin was exactly the opposite. A very precise English middle class professor who insisted on precision. So when Wittgenstein says there are an infinite number of uses of language, well, Austin used to say there are philosophers who say that there are an infinite number of uses of language, and then they give a list of 17 or 32. And Austin would say this with, you know, unspeakable contempt. I mean, oh my God, how could anybody? Austin once said to me about Oxford, there's a lot of loose thinking going on in this town. And I remember we shook our heads and we thought, all the way out the Iffley Road and the Woodstock Road and the Banbury Road, maybe all the way to Banbury itself, loose thinking. And Austin was against all forms of loose thinking. However, that made it impossible for him to understand a lot of things in Wittgenstein. So at one time when I was an undergraduate, I insisted on our little informal discussion group that we discuss Wittgenstein's private language argument. And Austin found it very uncomfortable, but his technique was to take everything dead literally. So he said, okay, next week everybody has to bring a box with a beetle in it, because Wittgenstein has a famous example of the beetle in the box. And then, he was being sarcastic. We didn't bring a box with a beetle in it. But at one point, Wittgenstein says, maybe there's nothing at all in the box. And Austin shook his head and said, a plain contradiction. First he says there's a beetle in the box, and now he says there's nothing in the box. Anyway, so I'm always amused when I read how much Austin was influenced by Wittgenstein. He was not. Now, Moore, that was somebody else. And in fact, I think maybe the most insensitive remark ever made about Wittgenstein was Austin once said, it's all in Moore. It's not all in Moore. It's quite different. But in any case, I just want you to see, this was Austin's most important idea, was that all utterances are the performance of speech acts. Okay, so let's probe that idea. Let's see how far we can get with that. Any more questions? I want everybody up with us now. Those are both good questions. Yes?
Yes.